Hello students, I am Sanjana Kavatagi, Assistant Professor, Department of Computer Science and Engineering, AITM, Belagavi. Let us continue with the video lectures on computer organization. This video is a continuation of module number 3, the memory system. In the previous video, I have studied in detail about the cache memory. In this video, I will be explaining a very important concept, mapping functions. So let us start with the video. We shall start with the concept mapping functions. To understand the possible methods for specifying where the memory blocks can be placed in the cache, let us understand some simple example. Consider a cache that is consisting of 128 blocks of 16 words each. That means one block contains 16 words. Such 128 blocks are there in the cache. Okay, so which is consisting of a total of 2048 words. You can consider it as a 2k words. Okay, and also assume that the main memory is addressable by a 16-bit address. Okay, so that means the main memory has 64k words, which we will weave as a 4k blocks of 16 words each. Okay, 64k is weaved as a 4k blocks each of 16 words each. Okay, so for simplicity we will assume that consecutive addresses refer to consecutive words. Okay, so like addresses 1 2 3 indicate words 1 2 3. Okay, for understanding purposes, the first method we shall study, that is direct mapping. So the simplest way to determine cache locations in which we can store memory blocks is the direct mapping technique. Okay, so in this technique, let us say block J of the main memory maps onto block J modulo 128 of the cache as depicted in the figure. This figure is figure 5.15 from the textbook, which is indicating a direct mapped cache. So what is happening in this technique is block J, say block J from the main memory is mapping onto block J modulo 128. What is 128 here? We have assumed that cache is consisting of 128 blocks. You can see the figure. We have cache starting from block 0, block 1 up to block 127. It is starting from 0 and ending at 127. So total of 128 blocks. Okay, as we have also discussed, main memory is consisting of 4k blocks. Okay, that is starting from block 0, block 1 up to block 4095. Okay, so this is main memory and this is cache. We are mapping a block of memory from main memory to a block in the cache using direct mapping. Okay, we are making use of modulo function here. So with the help of that, block J from the main memory is mapped to block J modulo 128 in the cache. So which means that whenever one of the main memory blocks, like for example 0, 128, 256 and so on, any one of these blocks is loaded into the cache, it is stored in the cache block 0. Okay, 0, 128, 256, any one of these, if it has to be loaded into cache, it will be placed in block 0. Next, if a block from main memory, that is block 1, 129, 257 etc. are stored into the cache, they will be stored into block 1 of the cache and so on. Okay, again, next, if I want to store any one of the block from main memory, that is block 2, comma block 130, comma block 258 and so on, this will be stored into the block 2 of the cache. Okay, since more than one memory block is mapped onto a given cache block position, contention may arise for that position even when the cache is not full. Means what? Since multiple blocks of the main memory are mapped to one of the block in the cache, contention means competition will arise in the cache for taking the position even when the cache is not full, because there are multiple blocks in the main memory which are mapping to the one of the block in the cache. So among themselves a competition will arise. Even though cache is not full, they will contend for the position to be taken in the cache. Okay, let us understand this with an example. For example, instructions of a program may start in block 1 and they may continue up to block 129. Okay, so possibly if there is any branch in the code, okay, so it will start in block 1 and continue up till 129. Okay, so as this program is executed, both of these blocks may be they have to be transferred to the block 1 position in the cache, because we have assumed that cache is of size 128 blocks. Okay, so the contention will arise here. Okay, so this contention will be resolved by allowing a new block to overwrite the currently resident block in the cache. Okay, so in this case a replacement algorithm has to be used, and this algorithm plays an important role, like which block has to be chosen to overwrite. Okay, so there the importance of replacement algorithms will arise, and we will study these replacement algorithms in the upcoming videos. So now how a placement of a block in the cache is determined? It is determined from the main address. The memory address can be divided into three fields, which is shown in the figure 5.15 from the textbook. You can see that it is divided into three parts. One is tag, block, and then word. Okay. So the lower order 4 bits select one of the 16 words in a block. Okay. So it will choose which word has to be selected from the block. So when a new block enters the cache, the 7-bit cache block field determines the cache position in which this block must be stored. Okay, and then the higher order 5 bits of the memory address of the block are stored in the five tag bits associated with its location in the cache. Okay, then they identify which of the 32 blocks that are mapped onto the cache position are currently resident in the cache. Okay, so as and when the execution proceeds, the 7-bit cache block field of each of the address generated by the processor points to a particular block location in the cache. And then the higher order 5 bits, so here the higher order and the lower order means that LSB and MSB. MSB is the most significant bit, LSB is the least significant bit. Okay, so the higher order 5 bits of the address are compared with the tag bits associated with that cache, with that particular cache location. Okay, so if both of them match, then the desired word is in the it is in that particular block of the cache. Okay, and then if there is no match, then the block containing the required word must first be read from the main memory and then loaded it into the cache. Okay, so the direct mapping technique is easy to implement, but it is not that flexible. Okay, so this flexibility you will understand when we study the other mapping functions. Okay, so this is about direct mapping. We shall study the other mapping functions in the next video. Thank you for watching.